Good morning, children. Again, we are doing the same chapter revision, that is data handling. We have completed already the some questions based on mean, median, mode and also probability. Now we are going to do the graph part. Data is organized and represented graphically so that it becomes easy to understand and interpret. So graph is always look comfortable for explanations. So and pictorial representation only, so children likes also. The representation of the data in the form of rectangles of uniform width is called a bar graph. So bar graph means we can see the rectangles with the equal width, uniform width. The representation of the data in the form of rectangles of uniform width is called a bar graph. That is the first graph we have studied. We are going to study here. A double bar graph can be used to compare the information related to two data. So double bar graph also there, bar graph also there. Double bar graph, what is advantage? We can compare the information related to two data. So when we can draw two data or do the graph of the two data in the same page, that is called a double bar graph. Both the graphs we have done the practice questions and exercise question also. Still we are going to revise one more time. So how many types of graphs you have to study? Two types, which are the bar graph and the double bar graph. Study the graph and answer the questions that follow. So graph is given to you. We have to do the interpretation of the graph only, or we have to draw the inferences from the graph. So what is the graph shows? Here it is itself, it is written that sections of the class 7, 7th A, 7th B, 7th C, 7th D and 7th E. E sections are there. In that, each section is having how many children? Let us see. 7th A is having 30 children, B is having 35, C is having 30, D is having 40 children, 7th E is having 35 children. So these are the informations clearly written here. Here you can see the label solution, so sections of the class 7, and here what they have written, number of students. So what type of the information we are getting from this graph? The class 7th is having how many children? Each section of class 7 is having how many children? Now, height of the bar shows the maximum number of children. So, which bar is having maximum height? 7th D graph. So, 7th D is having maximum number of the children. Which is minimum? Minimum here means 30 only. But both the class are having minimum. Which are they? 7th A and 7th C. Now, let us see the questions. How we can calculate. What information does the graph represent? So we already told this point, sections of class 7 and number of students. By using this label, we can write that one. Number of students, what is the solution for this one? Number of students in each section of class 7. Or we can say 7th A or 7th B or 7th C or 7th D class or E also. Okay, what is the second question? Find the total number of students. Let us take down the total number of students. So we should see the height of the bars, and we already discussed that A class is having 30, B is 35, C is 30 and D is 40, and the last class is also having 35. So let us write total number of students is equal to plus 35, plus 30, then 40, plus 35. So 60, 100 and 170 students. In which section number of the students is maximum? We already discussed this point. Which section? 7th D. How many students? 40 students. The table below gives the flavors of ice cream liked by the children, boys and girls of his society. Flavors: vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, mango, butterscotch. Boys and girls respectively. Vanilla for boys, that is 4 boys and girls 8. Chocolate 9 and girls 12. Strawberry flavor liked by boys how many? 3 and the girls 7. Mango flavor boys 8 boys whereas girls are 9. And butterscotch, boys are 13 and girls are 10 only. Draw a double bar graph using appropriate scale. So listen here, that is boys and girls, two datas are there. Boys also is there, girls also there. So we can compare which type of the graph should be used, double bar graph. So question itself, it is given that double bar graph to be drawn. Now let us see the double bar graph of the data. Okay. Double bar graph is already drawn here. So the last videos when we are teaching the concept, that time only clearly instructed that between the bars it should have a equal gaps, right? And when you are using the two datas, you should mark one data, or you should shade the data different from the other. So here boys we have made the shade, and the girls separately blank we have kept. So how the convenience scale we have taken? Vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, mango, butterscotch, all flavors we have taken on the x-axis, where y-axis we have taken as 1 unit or 1 centimeter equal to 2 children. So 2, 4, 6, 8, like that it will come. And what is the labeling should be done here? Number of children. Now here two datas are there, so key should be represented on their graph sheet. What is that one? Boys and the girls. Boys are the shaded one, girls are the blank one. Now scale, how we are written? Only y-axis we will take the scale. So scale on y-axis, 1 unit is equal to 2 children. And don't forget to mark here x and here y. So the double bar graph you have already learned how to draw. Draw correctly and check that equal spacing to be done between the bars. And it is better to have like this bars in 1 centimeter only, you divide it into 2 parts, or otherwise we can go for 1 centimeter also, but that will have a broader in bars, that is not looking good. So like this only it appears good. So it is left to your choice, because already you have learned how to draw the double bar graph or bar graph also. For this question, double bar graph, so be careful what is the labeling you are giving, that is to be written correctly. On x-axis we have taken flavor, on y-axis we have taken number of children, and scale is written, key is written. Don't forget to write the key also. So this is the graph which is based on the question given. Observe the following data. Days of the week: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Number of mobile phone sets sold equal to 50, 45, on Wednesday 30, on Thursday 55, on Friday 27, on Saturday 60. Draw a bar graph to represent the above information. So I can show you the graph later. Now let us do the calculation. Calculate the average sale during the week. Without knowing the graph also we can calculate this one. So I'll solve here only. Solution: average is equal to sum of the observations divided by number of observations. It is equal to 50, 45 plus 30 plus 55 plus 27 plus 60 divided by 6. It is equal to 267/6. So when you divide, we will get the answer 44.5. This is the average sale. Average sale is asked here. Average sale is nothing. but our arithmetic mean only. So mean means what is the formula? Sum of the observations by number of observations. We have to see the graph, then also we can do. Without seeing the graph also we can do. So 50, 45, 30, 55, 27, 60 we have added. And number of observation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So divided by 6. So it is equal to 267 by 6 equal to 44.5. Now let us see the graph now, because the question is asked to draw the bar graph. See the graph, we already completed. I'm not showing the steps. You can watch my videos, data handling. Already it is there in my channel. So those are not able to remember the concept, go through that one. So here, I just want to remind you that when you are doing the bars, in between the equal gaps should be the 1 centimeter gap here you left, means it should be 1 centimeter only between the bars. Children, what is the means wrong part they will do, means what is the mistake they will do, means here 2 centimeter they will take and here onwards 1 centimeter gap they will take. That is wrong. Everywhere 1 centimeter, in the beginning also 1 centimeter, in between the bars also 1 centimeter only. So we have completed the bar on Monday. What is the sale? 50. And Tuesday 45, Wednesday 30, and Thursday it is given that 55, and Friday it is 27, then Saturday it is 60. So these are the number of the mobile phone sets sold according to the respectively on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Don't forget to label the graph, that is days of the week, or we can say heading number of mobile phones sold on the y-axis. Now what is the scale taken? Scale equal to on the y-axis 1 unit of 1 centimeter equal to 10 mobiles, that is to be written. So this is the bar graph for that one. In the sub question it is also asked the average sales. Without doing the graph also we can calculate the average. So same formula, arithmetic mean we have used there, and we have calculated 44.5. that was one of the sub question, and graph was the another one. When we are doing the graph, don't forget to write the headings, days of the week, number of from mobile phones sets sold on that way, and the scale also. And here also we should write x-axis and the y-axis. The bar graph given below shows the marks of the students of the class in a particular subject. So it is given as a bar graph only. Now the 30 to 39, the mark is given. 40 to 49, 50 to 59, 60 to 69, 70 to 79, 80 to 89, 90 to 92. These 90 to 92 they are not given that 99 or 100. So 30 to 39, how many children are there? 4. Again, 40 to 49, just 2 only. 50 to 59, how many children were scored? 7. Again, 60 to 69, how many children? 12. And 70 to 79, how many children? 8. In the group 80 to 89, we can see that 6 are there. And 90 to 92, only how many are there? 4 are also there. If 40 is the, now study the bar graph and answer the following questions. If 40 is the pass mark, then how many students have failed? See, 40 is the passing mark, means 40 starts from here. So how many children are possible there? 4. Before 40 to 49, only 4 children are there. So 40 is the passing criteria. How many students are failed? Means below 40, how many are there? So 4 students failed. Why they are failed? They are coming in the category 30 to 39, not 40. Now next question. How many students got mark from 50 to 69? So our group is that 50 to 59, how many students are there? 7. Now the next group is 7 students, and the next group is 60 to 69. Then only the 50 to 69 means 2 groups are there. In 60 to 69, 12 students are there. So the total number of the students, is equal to 7 plus 12 equal to 19 for this category. 50 to 69 means 50 to 59 plus 60 to 69 will come. So 7 plus 12, what is the total number of the students? It is equal to 19. So if the students who scored 80 and above 80 are given merits, then how many get the merit holders are there? So 80 and above 80 means two category will come. One is 80 to 89, then 92, 90 to 92, that is 90 to 92. In 80 to 89, how many children are there? Six students are there. And in the last one, it is four students. So how many are the total? Total equal to 10 students. So 10 students will be awarded merit. So merit holder, 10 students are the merit holders. Now we have to find out what is the strength of the class. Strength of the class equal to means we should add everything. So strength of the class equal to 4, that is the first criteria, 4 will come. The second group in 40-49, we will get to 2. Again 50-59, it is 7. Then 60-69, it is 12. Then 70-79, it is 8. Then 80-89, 6. Then 90-92, it is 4. So what is the total number of the students? 4 plus 2, 6. Plus 7, 13. 15 plus 10, 25. Plus 8, 33. 39, then 43. So totally how many students are there? 43 students are there. You can check each bars and add the height of the bars. Then you can get the total number of the students. So we are winding up the complete revision of data handling once again. So today's video I'm winding up. Thank you.